Well, Amira, like you said, we've just received word that 200 of these cadets have been rescued. And this, I mean, as we've been covering this, we know that this has been ongoing for over 5 hours. So the fact that, you know, we know that there were at least 500 cadets within this hostel of this police academy, 200 have been rescued, over 30 have been injured. Hospitals are currently on high alert as we wait for more information as this operation continues. Amira?
And any idea as to who these militants might be and why they might be carrying out this kind of attack?
There has been no claim of responsibility yet in terms of who it could be. There are many possibilities. There are many militant groups that do operate in that part of Pakistan, in the southwestern part of Pakistan, which is the province of Balochistan. It's quite integral to Pakistan's geopolitical strategy and foreign policy at the moment. So it's very interesting to see who will take responsibility for such an attack. There have been attacks in the past, the most recent one being in August, when an offshoot of the Taliban took responsibility for this. But as the night progresses and moves into day, we're still to see who's been responsible for this opera attack.
All right, we thank you, Amira, for your reporting, Sophia Saifi in Islamabad. And of course, we'll continue to keep you updated on this breaking news story out of Quetta, an apparent hostage situation where hundreds of more cadets may still be trapped inside this training academy.